Hey everyone, Future Programmer here. In today's video, we will be finishing up Chapter 4 of the Python Fundamentals series with a fun and cool project, where we will be using our knowledge on Python lists. Let's get started! So today's program is going to be a word guessing game, and in my opinion, it's a really fun one, especially for a beginner level project in Python. And it's kind of like Hangman, just without the fancy graphics. So the goals with this program is firstly, we want to allow the computer to randomly choose words from a list of words and continuously ask the user to enter letters that they think are in the word that the computer chose. And there will be limited guesses before the game ends, and the computer is going to be able to address repeats when the user is guessing, and the progress of the game will be displayed onto the screen after each guess. So in this program, we'll be using conditionals to test conditions and using loops for repetition, functions for repeated routines, and lists to store array-like data. And last but not least, we'll be using the random module to randomly select words. In the previous two projects, we've been using the random.randint function, which returns a random integer between two numbers. To simplify our work this time, since we've learned about lists, we'll be using the random.choice function. So we'll be using this function so that the computer is going to be able to randomly choose words from a list of words. Before we use the function, we'll need to write imports random at the top of our file, and random.choice is going to return an element from a sequence data type, a sequence data that we pass into it randomly. So here's an example demonstration code that I have written. You can see we have imports random at the top of the file, and I have a list of instruments, which consists of piano, violin, cello, viola, and drum. And if I run this code, we'll see a list of 10 instruments printed out in a random way. So that's basically how random.choice works. We pass in the list inside the function, and it will choose a random element from that list. So let's get started coding this program. Alright, so right now I am in Sublime Text 3, which is what I usually use to write my programs. And feel free to use any code editor or any IDE that you want. Just make a file with a .py extension. I've called mine wordguessinggame.py. So this is where I'll be writing our program. The first thing we need to do is to, of course, import the random module so we can use the random.choice function. So import random. And don't worry about what this does, since we'll talk about the modules in a later chapter of this course. Just know that this will give us the ability to use random.choice. In this word guessing game, we'll have the computer randomly choose words from a list of words to give the user for them to guess. So let's make a function called choose word, where the computer is going to be able to choose a random word from a list of words. And that list of words, let's call it words, and let's make it a list. So in here, feel free to put anything you want in here. You can use entirely different words than what I'm using. So I'm going to use future programmer programming and Python. Let's just use those words. And let's use the random.choice. If I can spell choice correctly, random.choice function, and pass in words. So this is going to return to us a random word in this list. So it can be programming, it could be future, it could be programmer, it could be Python, and it's entirely random. So let's assign it to a variable called word. And let's actually make it lowercase since we have uppercase letters in here. And we'll return word from the choose word function. Now let's make a function called main, which is the main function of the game that handles the logic of the guessing and stuff. So let's actually have it take one parameter called word. So that's going to be the word used by the main function during one particular round. So in the main function, we will only give the user limited numbers of guesses before the game ends. So let's make a variable called guesses, which is equal to the length of the word which was passed in, multiplied by 1.5. And just to make sure it's a whole number, let's cast it or convert it to an integer. And let's also print out, you have the length of the word, or sorry, I mean, you are looking for a word that is, and then here's letters long. So you're looking for a word that is, say, 12 letters long or 15 letters long, whatever. And actually we have to convert that into a string so we can concatenate it to other strings. And afterward, let's make a while loop. While true, if chances is not equal to zero. So if the user still has chances left, we would allow them to input guesses. So guess is going to be equal to the input and we pass in guess as the prompt. Let's make it lowercase and we only take the first letter. So index zero is going to take the first letter of whatever's passed in here. So if the user guessed hello, then guess will be H. Before we have them guess, let's actually first print out, you have chances left. So however many chance the user has left. So you have, say, 5 chances left. And yeah, so now we need a way so that the computer is able to keep track of the number or the letters that the user has already guessed. So let's make a list called letters guessed, which is equal to an empty list at the start of the function. And as the user continues inputting guesses, we would append that. So let's do letters guessed.append guess. So this will add guessed to the end of letters guessed. And actually let's make it so that if guessed is not in letters guessed, so if the guess that the user just inputted is not in letters guessed already, we would add it to the end of letters guessed. So if the user inputted A, the letter A, 5 times, then letters guessed is only going to have 1 A since we have this conditional here. And now we need a way for the computer to tell whether the user has already gotten the correct word or not. So let's make another function called word in progress. And it's going to take 2 parameters. Let's give the parameters names of word and guesses. And in this function, we're going to have a string called word in progress, which is equal to an empty string. At first, we're going to have an empty string and we'll build it up to the current state of the user's word. So for each letter in word, if letter is in guesses, we would append the letter to the end of letters, to the end of word in progress. So we would add letter. Otherwise, word in progress plus equals, let's do an asterisk. And at the end, let's return word in progress. So let's talk about what this does. So at the start of the function, we have an empty string and it will iterate through the letters of word. If the letter has already been guessed, if it's already in guesses, we would put letter to the end of word in progress. Otherwise, we would add an asterisk to the end of word in progress. So let's take, say, Python as the example. If we have Python being the word and the user has guessed, say, the letter Y, then word in progress is going to see, so for each letter in word, so it's going to take a look at P. So is P guessed? Is P in guesses? No. So it's going to add an asterisk. And now it's going to take a look at Y. Is Y in guesses? It is, since it's right here. So we will put Y here. Is T-H-O or an N in guesses? No. So it's going to put 4 more asterisks. So this way, the user won't be able to tell what the other letters are, but the user will be able to see what position their correctly guessed letters are. So that's basically how this function works. Hopefully that makes sense. So now in the while loop here, let's make it so that let's first actually edit the print statement. So we want to print out word so far, which is going to be equal to word so far is going to be word in progress, and let's pass in word and letters guessed. So that's going to tell the user what state their current word is in. And after that, let's put letters guessed, which is just going to be equal to letters guessed. And actually, this is a list, so we need to convert it to a string. So let's actually see if this is working properly. Why don't we make outside the while loop? Outside the main function, let's make a while loop. While true, we would first choose a word. Let's give it a name of word, which is equal to choose word. And let's call main with that word as the word the user is trying to guess. But we do need a way so that the loop can be exited. So why don't we make it so that it's if input, would you like to continue? Dot lower dot starts with, and this is another string method. So if the string starts with the letter N, then we would break. And let's try to run this. Let me run this like that. And it says name chances is not defined. Oh, right. I mean chances is not guesses. I mean chances. So yeah, let's run this. Now you're looking for a word that is 11 letters long. We have 16 chances left. And the word so far, we can see everything's hidden since we have not gotten any correct letter or any letter at all. So let's first guess, say E. And we can see this is updated. And it says, okay, so it just guesses E. So we don't have any logic to deal with whether it's correct or not. So everything seems to work properly. Let's just make it so that it works even better. So in here, let's make it so that if word in progress, and we pass in word and letters guessed is equal to word, we will print out congratulations, you got the right word, which is equal to word. And let's actually first add the guessed to letters guessed first, since this letters guessed will be updated and it will be able to tell whether the word was correct or not. And after we print it out, we need to actually break so that we will break outside the while loop. Otherwise, so if the user has not gotten the correct word, we would first decrement chance by one, and then we'll be able to tell the user whether their guess was correct or not. So if guess is in word, then we would print out correct letter. Otherwise, we will print out, let's just print out guess is not in the word. And let's see if there's anything else we actually need to fix. I don't think, okay, so right now we have if chances is not equal to zero, we do need a else clause here. So else, so if the user has ran out of guesses, we would have a print statement telling them that. So let's do, oops, you ran out of guesses. The correct word was, and then the word. And remember to use the break statement to break outside the while loop so we can continue to the next part of the program. And I actually don't think there's anything else we need to do. Let's see if that is true. So we're looking for a word that is 11 letters long, 16 chances left. Let's try E, which was not in the word, and we have 15 chances left. So everything's working fine, and this is updated. This was not changed at all. Let's try A this time. And it says correct letter. So we got a correct letter, and we have 14 chances left. And we can see A is in the middle of the word in progress, and A is also added to the end of letters guessed. Let's try P, and we have 13 chances left. P is added to the first position of the word so far, and P is also added to the end of letters guessed. Let's continue. I bet R is in there, and also O is in there, maybe G, and maybe M and I and N. So we can see, congratulations, you got the correct word, which was programming, and would like to continue. Actually, why don't we just continue playing this and see if the running out of chances is correct. So let's try U and let's try A, which was not in the word. Let's continue trying A many, many times. And we can see, oops, you ran out of guesses. The correct word was future. And yeah, so the running out of chances is also working fine. So let's see. I don't think there is anything else that we need to fix in this code. All right, just to, I guess, recap what we did today. In this program, which is 50 lines long, we have made a pretty good word guessing game, in my opinion. So firstly, we imported random, and then we have a choose word function, which returns a randomly chosen word from this word list. And then we have a word in progress function, which takes the correct word and the list of guesses that the user has guessed, and it will build up the word from an empty string and add the correct letter if the user has already guessed that, and it will add an asterisk otherwise, and it will be returned at the end. And then we have the main function, where we have a list to keep track of the letters guessed, and we also have a chances variable that keeps track of how many chances the user has. And while the user still has chances left, we would allow the user to put input and add that input to the end of letters guessed. And if the user has gotten the right words, we will tell them that and break outside the while loop. Otherwise, we would decrement chance and then tell them whether or not they got the correct letter. And if the user ran out of chances, we will tell them they ran out of guesses and break the program. So that is pretty much it for this program. And if the user inputs N when asked whether or not they want to continue, then the while loop here breaks. So that's pretty much it for this program. Feel free to play around with any of those function or add any words here. There are only 4 words right now. Feel free to put anything here. And, you know, I would really encourage you to closely examine each of those lines of code and think about what those really do and how they impact the program in general. So yeah, congratulations on completing this program. And now we're at the end of this video, as well as the end of chapter 4 in the Python Fundamentals series. I hope you enjoyed this video. In the next video of this series, we're going to get started learning all about object-oriented programming. What's that? Well, you'll find out in the next video. In the meanwhile, make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe for more programming tutorials like this one. With that said, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you later.